Hello techies, in this session we will learn how to add or create a tag in a Teams by using an action called create a tag for a team, which is available under Microsoft Teams. Let me drag and drop this action onto the workspace. The main purpose of this action is to create a tag. First, we will see what is the purpose of a tag in Microsoft Teams. Tags are used to reach a group of people all at once very quickly. With the tags, we can categorize people based on attributes such as role, project, skill, training, or location. For an example, for the tags such as developer is a tag, manager is a tag, or designer is a tag, which enables us to reach group of people in the teams without having to type every single name. All right. Now, as we know, this create tag for a team action creates a tag in Microsoft Teams. Now, let me go back to the Microsoft Teams. And there you can see I'm having Teams orders such as Contiso, onboarding employees, build team. Now, where I can see these tags? Now, go for the team. And there you can see three dots, more options. Click on that. And there you can see manage tags. Click on that, which it will goes for the tags over here. Now, if you see in my Contiso, I don't have any tags over here for the Contiso. There you can see this Teams doesn't have any tags. To create some of you, you can notify a group of people all at once by mentioning @ tag over here, right? Now, what we are going to do, we are going to create a tag by using Power Automate Desktop actions, which are available in Microsoft Teams, right? There is an action called create a tag for a team. Now, what is the team name that we are going to select? Now I'm going to select from the drop-down. There you can see I'm having three teams such as Contiso, build team, and onboarding. I'm going to select Contiso. And the display name, I'm going to give the tag name over here as developer. All right. Now, the third parameter you can see here as user IDs. Now, if you're going to give the email ID over here, it will throw some error over there. Now, let me show you that error also. Now, I'm going to select the IA option over here, such as you can see over here, list of users separated by semicolons to add to the tag. If you want to add multiple people, then you are going to use semicolon over here. All right. First, as I said, I will show you an error first over here. I'm going to give the email IDs over here, such as Petty Fernandez, semicolon. I'm going to give ishael@m365.onmicrosoft.com. Right, I'm going to click on save. Now, whatever we have given email IDs in the user ID, that will be throws an error. Okay, that is the first portion which we are going to look up. Let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see the flow has failed. The reason is that you can see over here, cloud connector call failed with status code as bad request. Whatever we have given in the user IDs, that is throwing a request as bad request over here. In that case, this user ID, how can we go ahead and get it? Now, let me delete this user ID. Now, to get these user IDs, let me switch to the browser. I'm going to navigate make.powerautomate.com. And after that, I'm going to use the username and password, which we are going to give as a connection references, right? And then on the right-hand side, you can see the settings. And then I'm going for the admin center to get the user ID of the particular user, right? Which it will navigate to Power Platform Admin Center. Once it's navigated to Power Platform Admin Center, there you can see Microsoft Entra ID. Again, the all users, let's click on all users. There you can see I'm having all the users which are available for the Microsoft Teams, right? Now, in the particular organization. So I'm going to select Isha Langer. Now, if you observe over here, for the Isha Langer, I got all the details, basic info over here, such as user principal, that is ishael@m365.onmicrosoft.com. And object ID, you can see over here, this is the object ID. In our case, the user ID is nothing but the object ID. All right. Now from here, I'm going to get the user ID, that is object ID. I'm going to copy it. And then I'm going to give this user ID over here. And in the same way, for the Patti Fernandez, also I got it. I'm going to keep it after semicolon. I'm going to give the Patti Fernandez user ID. All right. This is one of the way. The another way is nothing but you can get it from the list members also. If you observe, in our previous tutorial, we have discussed about the list members action. From there, we got the user ID also. That user ID, we are going to give it in the user ID. All right, let me click on save. Now, let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see it is trying to create a tag for a team with the name of developer. The flow has executed successfully and the output has been stored inside my flow variable, that is create tag response. Let's double click on that. Now, if you see the properties of the variable, that is create tag response variable, there you can see O data context and the ID. ID for the tag. This is the ID for the tag. And the team ID name, team ID you can see over here. Display name, that is the display name we have given it as developer. Right, and the description we have given it blank, and the members count we have added 2 members for the particular tag. Right, now for the future purpose, you just remind this ID over here, which we are going to use this ID in the add a member to a tag action. All right, let me click on close. Now to show you the output from the Microsoft Teams, let me switch to Microsoft Teams, and then once again let me go back to the tags by clicking on manage tags. Now there you can see there are some of the tags have been created. The tags assigned to you is 0. Other tags, let me expand this. And there you can see with the tag name as developer with the members has been 2 has been added. And the description is null, imported from is null, right? Now we'll see the members by clicking on the members over here. Under the developer tag, I have added 2 members, that is Isha Langer, and their one is Patti Fernandez by using their user ID, right? All right, I hope you understand how to create a tag for a team by using create tag for a team with parameter as user ID as part of this tutorial.